What? else can you figure out with the title? Rain on the roof. Vlog. What does the title suggest to you? Just one thing, that rain is falling on the roof.
Yes.
Is there anything else?
The smell of the sand.
Even here, poet has described his memories, how he felt when he was a child. His memories have come back with the rain on the roof. With the rain falling, his memories also come back. So the poet is telling us about the memories he has of the rain. Because in the childhood, we have enjoyed rain more than we enjoy it now. So we also have that memories. Poet also has it. And that's why he has written this poem. So let us know his memories. And the sound of the raindrops falling on the roof, that is pattering sound.
Yes, sir.
You know, that is the real sound. When the raindrop falls on the roof, that pattering sound, but that is pattering sound. That is also a figure of speech. Onomatopoeia. Because that is original sound.
What, sir? What, sir?
Pattering sound.
Hey.
Figure of speech.
Which?
Onomatopoeia. Original sound of the words.
Yes, sir.
Pattering sound. So, the sound of the raindrops. The sound of the raindrops, which are falling on the roof, on his house, it brings the sweet memories of the past. These sweet memories of the past are refreshed with the sound of the rain on the roof. That is the introduction. Now we will read the stanza. We will read the first stanza.
Okay, sir. When the humid shadows hover over all the spheres and the millennium. When the humid shadow is over all starry spheres, and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears, what a brief bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead.
Okay, now the difficult word, see. Humid. In the first stanza, the word is given, humid. Humid means something which is full of moisture.
Moisture.
That is humid. The word is given over there. You don't have to write just for your knowledge. In the first stanza, the word is given, humid. It's full of moisture.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Then one more word is there. Over. Over. See, H-O-V-E-R. Can you see the word over?
Yes.
First and last word.
What is the meaning?
Over.
Don't know.
Move around something. Move around. Yes. Then, is there any other difficult word that you find?
Melancholy.
What is the meaning? Is there a
melancholy. Darkness.
What is the meaning?
The darkness.
Sad. Sorrowful. Sad. Then, cottage chamber. I'm not writing that. That is a compound word. Means two words are joined. Cottage chamber means nothing but roof. Roof of the poet.
Yes.
So that was the difficult words. Now, understand the stanza. The poet is saying that when the humid shadows over, see, in that language, poetic language, but if you understand, it's very easy. Humid shadows over means humid shadows means what? Dark clouds, which are full of water. When you see dark clouds, especially in rainy season, this season, why are they dark? Because they are full of water. Right? So the poet is saying that when the sky is full of these dark clouds, which are full of moisture, which are going to rain anytime, are full of water and are about to bring rain. Such clouds are around in the sky. They are hovering the sky. Means they are all around in the sky. Which kind of clouds?
Dark.
Full of moisture. And overall the starry spheres. It is not starry. It is starry. Starry means what? Full of stars. Full of stars. You see the sky is full of stars at night. So he has said starry spheres.
Sir, here it is not there. Sir, where you see a starry?
It says that it is not daytime, it is nighttime. Because when do we see the starry sky? At night.
Night.
We don't see starry sky during the daytime. So that was yesterday. And then what else yesterday? At that time, huge clouds, big clouds, which are full of moisture, they are moving around in the sky. And what else? The sad darkness of the night, because that is what we generally believe, human beings, that night is generally sadder as compared to day. Daytime we can spend easily. Night brings little bit sadness for the people, those who are depressed. So yeah. Night is sadder compared to day. So if there are the clouds which are moving, during the night time, that clouds bring sadness to the poet. But that sadness is wiped off by the raindrops which seem like tears falling from the sky. Now poet is comparing that raindrops with the tears. When someone is crying, the tears roll down. So poet is comparing that raindrops with the tears of the person who is crying. That is the comparison. And for comparison, this because of speech I use simile, metaphor, if you remember. Yeah, but this one is a word is comparing the raindrops with the tears rolling down from someone's eyes. So the poet is here is comparing the raindrops to the tears. He says that the dark sky, which seems to be very sad.
Yes.
Actually, sky cannot be sad.
Yes.
But actually, poet is just doing comparison over here. So he says that the sky, which seems to be sad, it appears as if it is crying, and the raindrops are tears shed by it. Poet says that sky is crying. Actually, it is natural phenomenon. The rain, if the water evaporates from the seas, it goes up, it comes down. You all know the water cycle, how the rain comes.
Yes,
it's a continuous water cycle. But poets, they use any language and they are in their own imagination. So poets say that the sky is crying and the raindrops which are falling are not raindrops, but they are the tears coming down from the sky. Sky is crying, he says. So here we are just learning the poet's imagination, nothing else.
Good imagination.
The poet is
there. The actual is the room in which the poet is sleeping. It is the room in which he is sleeping, his bed room. Yes. Then he adds that it is like a blessing to lie on the bed in his room. He says that right now he is lying, where is he lying? In his bedroom, what a chamber. So it is a blessing for him. It is a bliss since it is a thing which is enjoying a lot. And lying near the window in his bedroom is enjoying the rainfall. It is a blessing for him. It is a whole blessing that he has got. And he listens to the sound made by the raindrops which are falling on the roof of his house. That is the blessing for him. Understood this sense? Stanza 2.
Every tingle on the shingles, there's no hope in the heart. In a thousand premium placing in the region in star. And a thousand recollection waves that can catch in the wood as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof.
Okay. Now, tingle. What is tingle?
Tingle, sir.
Bringing sound.
Yes, sir. Better is the raindrops falling on the roof
is love. Then, is there any other word?
Limitances.
I'm explaining that. That is just an imagination. The more what is there?
Roof. Sometimes we also dream the things which have already occurred in our past life, right? So poem is feeling the same thing. Then the next stanza. May I?
Now in memory comes my mother as she used in years ago. Regard the darling dream all the year it left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel your fond look on me as I kneel. Which is played upon the fingers by the
pattern.
Now in memory comes my mother as she used in years ago to regard the darling dreamers as yet she left them till the door. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I list to this refrain. This is played upon the shingles by the pattern of the rain.
Okay. Now see the words which are given. In the third stanza. Yeah, is the old English word. Poets use it means before.
Which year this poem was written?
Dawn. Means early morning, when the first sun rays come in the sky. Early morning. Then, now you will think this is not a early morning, but in this poem, this means listen. It is also an old poetic word which was used. It means listen. Poets used it in the past. Don't come back like necessarily. First three benches.
Sir, I
now my request will change in order and you will go out.
Sir, big friend.
Repeated sound. Constantly the rain is falling on the room. Repeated sound. The rhythm that rain creates. That is refrain. That actually creates kind of music over years. That is refrain. Now, I'll explain. So here the poet introduces now the most important stanza. Understand, only then you will be able to learn the question answers. Because poems are shorter in length, but the language is different. So only if you understand, you can learn the question answers. Otherwise, you will just bug up. That is not what I want from you. Please understand the third stanza is very important.
Sir, what's the reason to learn?
No. See, third stanza. So here the poet introduces his mother. Now he brings him to see his mother, poet's mother. Why? He says that he is dreaming of his mother. Do you think mother is alive now?
No.
Poet's mother?
No.
No. Only then he recalls her. As he had told in the previous stanza, in the second stanza he had told us that rain brings memories of the past. In the second stanza, what did poet tell us? That rain brings the memories of the past. It is the memory of his mother who is no longer alive. Mother is no longer alive. So in the past, she used to love him a lot when she was alive. And mother will love the child a lot. We know that. So she used to consider him, mother used to consider the poet her darling, close to heart. And she would let him sleep till the daybreak, even when the poet is dreaming. Mother would not wake the poet up in the morning. Mother would let him sleep because the poet would be dreaming. And mother would pamper him and let him sleep. So poet recalls mother's memories now, which he already told us in the second stanza. The poet can still feel that his mother is looking at him. You know, sometimes we look at the sky, our forefathers or our elders.
Yes.
Those who have already left us, who are already in the heaven, we look at the sky.
Sir.
We try to recall the memories. We think that they are looking at us through the stars. We have also seen in the movies. Yes. So, poet here.
Regards
is the love and affection that you want to pass on to someone else.
Sir, I got a question. Who are godfathers?
Godfathers or forefathers?
Godfathers.
Godfather, you can consider anyone. See, that is irrelevant.
All father or godfather, they are.
Godfather is someone whom you consider, to be supreme than you, whom you follow, and whom you consider that is your ideal, and you follow each and everything said by that person.
I know only.
Yes. 1 second. Let me complete.
Okay.
Then you ask. In between, if you keep on asking, I will not be able to complete this.
Okay, sir. Right.
Last bench. All ears. All ears. So the poet can still feel that his mother is looking at him as he listens to the song made by the raindrops falling on the roof. That song which raindrops are making, falling on the roofs, on the roof. Through that, the mother is looking at the poet, he thinks. Stop that. Stop that one. So the poet can still feel that his mother is looking at him as he listens to the song of the rain falling on the roof. Rain drops falling on the rooftop of his room, just above his room, you can hear that sound. So the sound of the rain makes him correlate the past with the present. He is living in present, but the sound of the rain falling on the roof is connecting the past with the present. Right now, for the poet. And that is why the poet is moved by the sound of the raindrops. Why is he so much touched? Why is he so much emotional? He is moved because he recalls his mother, who is no more alive. And that is why the poet is moved by the sound of the raindrops falling on the shingles of his room. Shingles means, as I told you, the rectangular tiles above his room. The raindrop is falling on that, and that is making the sound, pattering sound. And it is creating a sweet rhythm. And yes, whenever he hears the sound, it brings the memories of the past and he is reminded of his
mother.
Whenever he hears the rain on the roof, he is reminded of his mother. Sweet memories of the past, his mother used to sit beside him and used to pamper him and used to let him sleep till the dawn, till the early morning, so that he can complete his dreams. The mother would not disturb, just pamper him. That's it.
God's skinny.
Now, yes, it is not over. Write the questions.
Sir, taking the questions.
Thank you.